And what's interesting is that you explained the big causes of heart disease, but you didn't really mention cholesterol, which of course for so many years has been sort of put forward as the big reason people get heart disease. And quite frankly, most people are terrified of the word cholesterol. They will go and get their bloods tested and they come back and they're scared about what their cholesterol might mean, and they've been put on statins, etc. So this whole, you know, background to cholesterol, could you sort of explain where did this all begin? Where did this obsession and fear with cholesterol come from?
So the fear, Bobby, came from the fact that from 1920, really the obsession or concern with heart disease started in 1920s and then built up certainly to 1950s, 60s, 1970s. So the death rates from heart disease started to increase, and scientists and doctors wondering what's going on, what's causing this. And by the way, it wasn't until certainly, I would say at least the late 60s, early 70s, where there was a broader, I mean, even later than that, an acceptance of the impact of smoking, because the tobacco industry were very good at suppressing information that allowed doctors and the public to understand that actually smoking was a big factor in that. So imagine doctors are trying to figure out what's going on. And then a number of studies were carried out. One of the most famous ones is called the Framingham Heart Study. And that started in 1948 in Framingham, Massachusetts in the United States, and followed up 5,000 people, you know, young and middle-aged, and over a 30-year period, to try and work out what were risk factors for heart disease. And from Framingham, we figured out high blood pressure was a problem, type 2 diabetes, for example, and also high cholesterol. But the people in Framingham, where there was a development of high cholesterol associated with heart disease, were actually at the extreme end. So we call this familial hyperlipidemia now, which affects about 1 in 250 people, and is genetically very, very high levels of cholesterol. What they found in Framingham, though, which is interesting, is that people where there was very, very high levels of cholesterol, there was a strong association with heart disease, premature heart disease.
Right.
But also people at the very lower end didn't tend to get heart disease. So people with genetically very low cholesterol, which is only about 5% of the population. But for the overwhelming majority of people, it wasn't a useful determinant. Okay. And it was felt and thought, okay, there must be a linear association. And because people with very low cholesterol, which is predominantly genetically determined, by the way, didn't develop heart disease, therefore lowering it must be the solution. And then lots of trials and drug trials and dietary trials started taking place, and it became almost a gospel truth without that definitive answer that would lowering cholesterol make any difference. We fast forward to where we are now, and I actually co-authored a paper a couple of years ago in BMJ Evidence-Based Medicine with two cardiologists, where we decided let's look at all of the drug trials, industry-sponsored trials, to see whether there was any clear correlation with lowering cholesterol in both people at low risk of heart disease and high risk with preventing heart attacks and strokes. There was none.
Wow.
So even though there was a... how I'm trying to explain this is that these are markers of maybe heart disease development, but on themselves may not be the cause. There may be something else going on. So if you look at people with FH as well, with genetically very high levels of cholesterol, so this would be an LDL of at least 4.9 millimoles per liter.
Okay, and LDL, just to explain,
is a so-called bad cholesterol, okay, low-density lipoprotein.
Yeah.
But it isn't that bad, as people think, because certainly cholesterol has many roles in the body, right? And one of them is thought to be in the immune system. And people with low levels of cholesterol, there is an association with cancer and with development of things like infections like pneumonia. So there's an issue there. What even people with familial hyperlipidemia, who tend to be more at risk of developing heart disease prematurely, even when you look at those patients, the ones that develop heart disease versus the ones that don't, because many of them actually live normal, healthy lives without treatment, without even though their cholesterols are through the roof and don't get heart disease, there's no difference between the LDL levels in the people with heart disease and the people that got it and people that didn't, which suggests there's something else going on. Yeah. And we think that the people that tend to develop heart disease are people who may have something else in the blood with abnormal clotting factors, for example. So this is what we're trying to change the understanding so we can be more precise in treating the right patient with the right drug at the right time or the diet or the lifestyle intervention.